friends, welcome to Krishna's IAS. And today I am going to discuss about an important question which asked by EPPCS in 2019. Basically, I start an important series in which I will discuss about how to write answer about the question of anthropology optional. So today we have to discuss about an important question from UPPCS exam from paper 1st in anthropology. So question is that is very important question asked by UPPCS in a genetic section or human genetic section. So question is that, explain the application of human genetics. Explain the application of human genetics. Application of human genetics. Right? And this question for 10 marks. So this is also important for us. But when we try to write answer about that question, that is open-ended question, and because we have to write application of human genetics, so there is many application of human genetics in our contemporary society. Because this question for 10 marks, so we have to write our answer in 150 words. So this is also important for us, because we have limited words, we have limited time for writing the answer of this question. So when we are going to write answer about that question, first thing, you have to define human genetics, right? And through that you can write your introduction, because introduction is very important when we try to write answer about any question. So first, you have to define or introduce or write introduction about human genetics. So simply, when we try to define human genetics, it has two important aspects: a study of human heredity and a study of human variation. So human genetics is an important branch of genetics, deals with the study of heredity and variation in mankind. We study how gene passes from one generation to next generation. So basically, in human genetics, we study about inheritance of genetical trait of mankind from one generation to next generation, and we also study about variation, because genetical expression of trait, it is depend on interaction between genetical factor and environmental factor. So we also study variation. So this is human genetics. This is the core concept of human genetics. And when you try to write your answer, you have only write what is human genetics within 2 or 3 lines, because we have to write our answer in 150 words. But when you try to write about application, right? This section is very broad. There are many applications of human genetics. in human being or in our contemporary society. So when you try to write answer about the application of human genetics, you have to give attention about our syllabus, right? And first you try to write those important points which available in your syllabus and in which we have to study about application of human genetics, right? So when you try to write application of human genetics, so first important thing you have remembered, it is apply for the study of human disease, right? First important thing, it is apply for diagnosis, screening, prevention and treatment of human disease. Second important thing is that knowledge and data and method of human genetics is applied in forensic screening or that apply in the field of forensic anthropology, which we study in our syllabus. Third important thing, you have to write in the field of eugenics. Next, in the field of reproductive biology, next, transgenic plant and animal and next stem cell research and next it is also useful for the study of human evolution or social purpose, right? So there are many applications of the knowledge of human genetics in our contemporary society. So we try to understand one by one how knowledge, data, theories and methods, techniques of human genetics are applied for the betterment of the life of mankind, right? So first important thing, when you try to understand about application of knowledge, data, method and techniques of human genetic care, we apply that knowledge and data in the field of human disease, both genetic disease and non-genetic diseases. And in non-genetic diseases, it is also applied for infectious and non-infectious diseases. Right? So we apply the knowledge and data and method of human genetics for the diagnosis or screening or prevention or treatment of human disease. So first, when we are talking about genetic disease, this knowledge is applied for single gene disorder multifactorial gene disorder क्रोमोसोमल डिसऑर्डर एंड नेक्स्ट एक्वायर्ड सोमैटिक सेल डिसऑर्डर. सो आई ऑलरेडी सेड दैट नॉलेज ऑफ ह्यूमन जेनेटिक्स इज अप्लाई इन द वेरियस एस्पेक्ट ऑफ mankind. Because we have limitation, we have to write our answer in 150 words. In this condition, we have give only one, two or three examples related to each and every point. So first important thing is that when we study about a single gene disorder, for the diagnosis of single gene disorder, their prevention, their treatment, we utilize Mendel law of inheritance. Because by the knowledge of Mendel law of inheritance, we can capable to understand about the mode of inheritance of single gene disorder. Second important thing is that we can capable to do screening of single gene disorder through the using technique of DNA technology or another important technology which developed in human genetics. We can also utilize karyotyping for the understanding of the single gene disorder, as well as we can capable to do a screening about chromosomal disorder through karyotyping. We utilize amniocentesis method for the diagnosis of prenatal disease, or we have to do prenatal diagnosis by the application of karyotyping and amniocentesis method, that types of method. So first important thing is that we have utilized many method for the diagnosis of genetic disease. And when we got evidence about genetic disease, their pattern, so on the basis of a study of mode of inheritance of that particular genetic disease, we are using genetic counseling for the management of genetic disease in human population. Because data we found from screening of genetic disease, and we utilize pedigree analysis method for genetic counseling, and through that we can capable to manage genetic disease in our population. This data is also useful for the selection of mate, for taking decision for reproduction of child, right? So first important thing, we have to understand that application in the field of genetic disease. Third important thing is that now we are capable to treat some genetic disease through gene therapy, right? So we are capable to do gene therapy in two ways: germ line gene therapy and somatic सेल लाइन जीन थेरेपी, राइट? सो थ्रू दैट वी आर कैपेबल टू ट्रीट सम इम्पॉर्टेंट जेनेटिक डिजीज, बट मेनी जेनेटिक डिजीज वी आर नॉट कैपेबल टू ट्रीट दैट इन प्रेजेंट सिनेरियो, बट वी आर कैपेबल टू डू मैनेजमेंट ऑफ दैट जेनेटिक डिजीज इन आवर पॉपुलेशन. सो नॉलेज, डेटा, थ्योरीज एंड मेथड्स ऑफ ह्यूमन जेनेटिक्स इज अप्लाई फॉर द अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ ह्यूमन जेनेटिक डिजीज. नॉट ओनली अंडरस्टैंडिंग, अंडरस्टैंडिंग देयर कॉजेज, अंडरस्टैंडिंग देयर मोड ऑफ इनहेरिटेंस पैटर्न, हाउ टू प्रिवेंट आवर पॉपुलेशन थ्रू दैट जेनेटिक डिजीज एंड हाउ टू ट्रीट दैट. सेकेंड, वेन यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट इन्फेक्शस डिजीज, सो वी डेवलप DNA प्रोब, राइट? वी डेवलप DNA प्रोब बाय एप्लीकेशन ऑफ नॉलेज ऑफ ह्यूमन जेनेटिक्स विच इज अप्लाई फॉर डायग्नोसिस ऑफ इन्फेक्शस डिजीज. As for example, if you have here the name of RT-PCR, so that RT-PCR technique developed for diagnosis of COVID due to application of knowledge of human genetics. We utilize many monoclonal antibody for the diagnosis of infectious diseases. In non-infectious disease, basically for the analysis of cancer, oncogene is an important gene which is responsible for cancer. So we got knowledge about oncogene on the basis of a study of human genetics, so we can capable to understand cancer also in the light of the knowledge and data of human genetics. Second important thing is that human genetics is also applied for the prevention of diseases, right? Prevention of diseases. So for prevention of diseases, we have developed many vaccine. As for example, COVID vaccine is developed in very limited time due to application of the knowledge, method and data of human genetics. We develop anti-malaria, anti-hepatitis B, anti-rabies vaccine due to development of the knowledge in the field of human genetics. Third important thing is that we utilize knowledge and data of human genetics for the treatment of disease in human being, treatment of human disease. We are capable to produce hormones, proteins by the application of knowledge of human genetics. Now we are capable to produce artificially insulin, which is utilized for the treatment of blood sugar. In the field of pharmacogenetics, we apply knowledge of human genetics for the development of various types of medicine. So knowledge of human genetics is useful for the treatment of not only genetic diseases but also non-genetic diseases. Monoclonal antibody produced by the application of knowledge of recombinant DNA technology, which is also utilized as a medicine for the treatment of many kinds of diseases. So, knowledge of human genetics is useful for the diagnosis, prevention, and treatment of human diseases, both genetic and non-genetic diseases. Second important thing, it is also apply in the field of forensic science and forensic anthropology, basically knowledge of human genetic disease utilized for personal identification. So it is utilized for identification of criminal and victims, both. Here we utilize DNA fingerprint. So that DNA fingerprint or DNA profiling developed due to application of knowledge of human genetics. So by the application of knowledge of human genetics, we are capable to do criminal investigation on the basis of genetic data, right? So we can analyze murder, rape like criminal in the light of the data and technique of human genetics. Second important thing is that it is also utilized for paternity and maternity dispute settlement. It is utilized for settlement of paternity and maternity like dispute or decision making taken on the basis of application of knowledge of human genetics for the solution of paternity and maternity like dispute. Another application of the knowledge of human genetics in the field of eugenics. This is an important branch of genetics which give focus to improvement of genetic health of population by the application of knowledge of genetics. So if we try to develop genetic health of our population, eugenics give focus to those persons who are genetically healthy, they reproduce more and more child. Means we promote those persons who are genetically healthy to reproduce more children. But we impose a restriction on those persons who are genetically unhealthy, unfit. So this is the concept developed by John Dalton in the 19th century. But there is some ethical issue behind that concept, application of that concept, but that concept developed in the field of human genetics due to application of knowledge of human genetics. Another important thing is that we utilize knowledge of human genetics in the field of reproductive biology, right? Reproductive biology. In the field of reproductive biology, we are capable to do prenatal diagnosis on the basis of some method developed by human genetics like karyotyping or amniocentesis method. So, by the application of these types of method, we are capable to do a screening of embryo. In the early stage of reproduction, we are capable to understand about genetic health of embryo or fetus. Second important thing is that we are capable to do sex determination in prenatal stage about embryo and fetus, right? This is applied. In our country, there is a restriction on sex determination, but in US and Euro-American country, this is not restricted. So we apply the knowledge of human genetics for the determination of sex also. Another important thing is that We can understand process of human evolution in the light of the data of human genetics. We have developed DNA dating method. So now we utilize DNA dating method for the dating of fossils remains. Data we found from Human Genome Project. According to the data of Human Genome Project, 99.9% human beings are similar in their genetic makeup. So racism become myth. No any race is superior or inferior. If we apply that scientific data which comes from human genetics, then the theory of racism became irrelevant. Indirectly, we utilize knowledge of human genetics in the field of transgenic plant and animal production of transgenic animal and plant. Recently, stem cell research became very popular and it has many applications because we are doing somatic stem cell research. So we can capable to do organ transplantation by the help of stem cell technology. So these are the important application of knowledge of human genetics, and on the basis of you can capable to write your answer because this is very broad area. So you can write on that important point because we have to write 150 words, and on the basis of that you can get very good marks. So on the basis of that discussion, you can write your answer on that question, explain the application of human genetics. Thank you.